Hi, my dear ones. Okay, we're going to take on an awesome topic today. It is about disassociation and using it to our advantage. If you have experienced complex PTSD, if you had trauma as a child, and if you know what disassociation is, in other words, a zoning out, I've got good news for you. You can use disassociation to your advantage in a practice of meditation, in a practice of managing your mind and getting to know yourself better. This is so important. I was so excited to feel into this. So when we disassociate, we are familiar with zoning out, aren't we? We know what to do, like we've gone there. Many people who approach the practice of meditation or mindfulness are trying to learn how to let go of strictly a material, I'm here existence. And they're trying to kind of cut through into the subtle layers, the subtle realms. Well, guess what? You've been doing that since you've been young. You've got that part. Use it to your advantage in that, in your meditation practice, your focus, since you know what it feels like to go and journey into the subtle realms, your focus is now coming back into the body. Your focus is now feeling here and now. I'm in my body, feeling the breath, experiencing the senses in the room, experiencing the sounds in the room as you meditate, experiencing the smells in the room as you meditate, experiencing how the body feels as you meditate. The good news is you've done the hard work. Okay, you've done the hard work of cutting through the subtle realms and being in a more open, expansive field. I'm not saying that's the ultimate empowered field. You've done the hard work of going to the more expansive field that you've got. Now your work is coming back into the body. When you come to quiet time, when you come to mindfulness, when you're running, when you're in nature, when you're in meditation, I encourage you to use the disassociation to your advantage, work it to your advantage, and simply allow the meditation to be about being here and now and in your body and with your breath and in your skin and feeling the body and smelling the smells and tasting the tastes in your mouth. So you've got this. Use it to your advantage. I don't even like the term disassociation anymore. It's a positive term. Think of it in a positive term. Think of yourself as you've cut through just a strong, rigid existence. You've journeyed through more subtle realms, through more refined awareness. So now your practice is, I got that, and I'm going to be here. I'm going to be now. I'm going to be relevant. I'm going to be in my body. I'm going to be authentic. I get to be who I am because I understand the more expansive part of myself. Let's use it to our advantage. If you've experienced trauma, it does not need to keep you in a stronghold. Don't let disassociation be this negative term. Keep checking in, keep tuning into these channels. We're going to do more mindfulness meditations where I keep bringing you back to your authenticity, back to the body, back to your senses, back to the here and now. Let's do this. We're doing this together. If you have any thoughts on this, any questions, please put them in the comment section below. I can't wait to hear from you, and we're going to keep this going. See you soon.